Hello everybody and welcome to episode 21 of Infinity Expert Mode. I'm Fixit and today is time to address the aqueduct because right now it is basically hovering in the air. So I just did this, these long pillars to kind of see about the spacing and stuff, and what it looks like is it looks like I'm going to need to take down this tree, I think, because they're the way I'm going right now there should be a pillar like right here. And that's going to conflict with the tree, and then one right here, and then one right here, which will actually be perfect. So, let's see, I can just come down like this, and just see. I just want to build the one block pillars for now, just to know, like, about where it's going to, like, where it's going to come down. So then I'll skip this one, and then do this one right up. Oops. Oh, no. Oh, that's what happened before. I did that before. When I was building it, it broke into those, like, these things, and because I accidentally hit my chisel, because my pick is always in slot 3. Because I usually have my hammer in slot 2, so that's the confusion. So, if, I don't know, if you checked out anything else on my channel, I've been really having just a blast on the server playing the Direwolf 1.10 pack. That has been so much fun, but I've been thinking about, I want to get back here. I want to do some fun stuff. I want to do some stuff with tech. I want to finish my gardening can, watering can, rather. That's one of my real immediate goals that I want to do, but I just don't think that I am there yet. I spent like a good deal of time, I don't know, a couple days ago, probably building, trying to get all the like really the extraordinary amounts of materials for this watering can, all these seeds from AgriCraft and stuff, and I just didn't feel like doing it tonight. I want to do some building and kind of hover mode, please. There we go. I want to get some of this building done and just kind of move forward with at least the farm aspect. I'd like to actually work on the farm building coming up soon. But what I'm going to try to do is attempt to stagger like maybe a building episode or two or three, and then get in some like tech episodes or two or three. So again, this series is all about world building. So if you're just stopping by to see, you know, the 1.7.10 Infinity mods, well, this might not be the place for you. I'm going to do all that stuff for sure, but I'm also going to be doing a good bit of building. So that looks like a pretty good height. I kind of like that. Now, obviously there's no detail yet, but I think what I need to do is probably fly back to the base and grab my lumber axe, or an axe of any kind, really. And while I'm there, I'll probably recharge my jetpack. But I want to make sure that, I guess I'm going to cut down that tree. I have like a moral problem with cutting down custom trees on the server, as I always talk about, but I think I just need to do it. Also, another thing I need to do down there, I really like the lookout tower. I added a little bit more detail the other day. I think it's really close. I want to put a flag on top. I might want to raise the top of the roof. As a matter of fact, you know what? I'm going to go do that right now. I thought of it the other day, and then I forgot, but I have a lot of wood planks. So let's get a few of these, and I need a tool, so it actually wouldn't hurt to have both axes, actually. I don't have room for both axes. Oh, no. What can I get rid of? Well, nothing. I can't actually get rid of anything. All right, let's throw a couple things in here. I can throw these in for now because I'm not about to do detail quite yet. Good, let's throw the axe in. And then what I want to do is I want to get some regular wood stairs. Oh, so you know what's messing me up is the Infinity server doesn't have Java, so the storage drawers are set to their default, which is shift click to do a stack, regular click to do one. This is the opposite because this is set to match Java, which makes a lot of sense when you have both. But since I'm bouncing back and forth between series, that is not all that convenient for me. So I need to at some point, oh, I'm doing the wrong thing. I need to at some point switch that up so it matches. So, excuse me, some delicious hot coffee. Everyone in my family, it's only 9 o'clock and everyone's either in bed or going to bed, so I actually have some time. Oh man, I gotta address the generator situation down here too. Yeah, so I think what I'm gonna do here, where's my regular axe? I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take off these and build this up. Dude, are you serious? Do I have any? I don't have any regular cobble, but I can make some. And I'm pretty sure I have a tinker's table. You know, another thing is that in this series, you can repair tools in a regular, like, tinker's crafting station. But in the other one, I clicked on with my chisel. In the other one, you can't. So you have to have a tool station or a tool forge to do it. But that's fine. Doesn't matter to me, but it is a little bit confusing. It's one of the... Another one of the kind of confusing things I need to just try to kind of remember. So I think what I'm going to do is something like this. Right? So this way... Let's see. Yeah, I think that's what I want. And then what I want is... Let's see. This. Something like this. And actually, you know what? This... has got to go too, and I might as well just take this too, because then I use the stairs like that. This will make it more pointy at the top, which would be nice, and I likely didn't have room for this. Oh, I do have the fence is what I was going to say, but cool. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's definitely better. Definitely better. It's not so chubby there at top. It's kind of spreads out a little bit. So, another thing, so I'm going to fly, let's see, where am I going to fly? Oh, shoot, whoa, I did not have hover mode engaged, and my hang glider, oh, I almost fell to my death, okay. So, I don't need to recharge it yet. Let's head back over here. While we're flying, I want to take a look here. Let's see. Alright, so the reason why I want to do the aqueduct first here, sorry this tree, I hate what I'm about to do, is the reason why I want to do the aqueduct first is because I want the aqueduct completely set so then it can go into the farmhouse in a really natural looking kind of way. Oh, that's funny, you know what, it didn't even occur to me. Yeah, so, okay, so that's something. These are, like, custom leaves, right? So they're not going to decay at all because they are set at the right location. So, I can't believe this, but I have to go back. I could just break them, but I actually need oak leaves to repair some of the damage that my harvester did, so I think I'm going to go back, and I actually, for some reason that I can't even explain, I have a lot of pairs of shears, so I'm gonna grab a couple and just shear down this tree. So I'll tell you what, no need to watch that. I will grab that, do that, wipe that out, and then I'll be back for more of like kind of the building portion. So I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So I cut down that tree and I got a whole bunch of leaves, which is nice. That's gonna be really helpful to kind of redo my jungle. I'm pretty sure that those big sort of junk... Darn, I do that every time. I'm pretty sure that those pretty big jungle trees are oak leaves. I'm not completely sure, but if they're not, I can deal with that later, but I'm pretty confident that they're oak trees, so... Alright. Oh, that's not right. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is I'm just continuing this sort of five-block X pattern. Here, and I'm kind of keeping an eye on my fuel, and I need to remember to sleep, actually, but, whenever my fuel gets down to, like, 20% or so, I'll just jet back to base and refill again. Anyway, so yeah, so this has been fun. I've missed this world. I've certainly missed this texture pack, because with the 1.10, I'm using default texture pack. Well, look at that dumb pillar of earth. That's not gonna do at all. Yeah, not at all. Alright. Anyway, so I've been using default texture pack, and I have not used default texture pack in, like, I mean, years, probably. Probably more than that. What we have done almost since I started my server, actually, no, since I started my server, what we have done is we've either done, like, a very small, like, 10 mod or less mod pack, or if we used a pack, we used a pack that was, like, completely done. Like, it was basically final release, kind of like this one is, actually. So, the texture packs and everything were great because it was always completely completely finished. No need to push my luck. Oh man, I need a better weapon soon. Anyway, so I've always had like basically a completely finished texture pack, which is awesome. But with the 1.10, that is not a thing yet, as far as I can tell. Anyway, so if I'm wrong, you know, please feel free to shoot me out a message. So, but anyway, so I have been doing that. You know, one thing I wanted to ask, if anyone's watching this, I started using a little bit of kind of atmospheric background music. In my 1.10 in my Direwolf series, I just thought it'd be fun, and it fits that theme. It fits like a very sort of sci-fi, ocean, futuristic sort of almost New Agey sort of theme that I'm building. This one obviously is medieval. Do you think that some like atmospheric sort of medieval music would enhance this? Would it be a good thing? If you do, that's a pretty easy thing for me to add. I could do that. Maybe it'd make me have more fun playing, actually, too. Especially since this series has so much building. So that's like the minimum I could possibly do. And look, already that just like that helps. And this isn't even a finished building yet, and already helps. So that's pretty cool. All right. So let's see. The next thing I need to do is I think I want to add a bigger base, and let's see, I probably want to add that. Do I have a shovel here? No, not a big deal, but all right, so I probably want to add a base that goes kind of like this around, and something like this, I think. Now, this is the experimental portion, so a base and then one. Oh, actually, you know, I did that by accident, but I kind of liked it, maybe. Three. I may need to fill this in, because I don't want mobs to spawn in there. So how about this? How about this? Like, go one, two, three. Oops. I'm taking so much fall damage. Okay. So how about something like that for, like, the base of the aqueduct? Oh, that looks pretty cool. All right. So, yeah, definitely want to fill that in. At least to you know, so it's a one by one block. Yeah, definitely. Okay. That's cool. Eventually, someday in the far, 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 far future, I may have magnum torches around here, which would be super nice. I wouldn't have to worry about mob spawnings. So how about that? How's that look? Does that look you know, like bulky enough to hold something like that up? I think so, probably. And then what I could do is I could use one of these like connected textures inside of it, maybe something like this. Oh, that looks pretty cool. I could do something like maybe iron bars, and like maybe iron bars and like light of some sort, but this might be okay to not be lit up because it wouldn't be lit up really. Why would you light up the base? Yeah. Yeah, I like that, I think. At least to start with, this is not finished. But that's a pretty cool start, I think. So let's do like this. So how about here? I gotta kind of figure out like where the bottom of the base will be, I suppose. So that'll be okay. That. And that's gonna have to be. Is that messing it up? So let me see. One, two, and then the three. Three, connect that. Okay, right. I'll break this one. How about one, two, and just connect that. That's cool. That works. So maybe I should actually break these. That way I can see the texture in the bottom, right? Maybe it matters? I'm not sure. And let's go. Is this right? Yeah, I mean, yeah, this is right, okay. One, two, cool. Yeah, okay. This works. It's, the one up there, up at the top of the hill, may be a little bit tricky, I'm not, oops. didn't mean to do that one. This one's got to go. Okay, cool. I think that's good. Now the only thing that has to go are these two. And how can I get to, how can I get this one? This one, I guess. Now, can I see any of these others? I don't think that I can, so I probably don't need to replace them. Oh, I can see that one. Okay, that's pretty good. Yeah. Yeah, I like it. Okay. I'd really love to leave that melon there, but I'll move it if I have to. So let's see. 1, 2, 3. I guess I need to go like this. You know what? I'm gonna make it like this height. Yeah, that'll be good. Not this. Okay. That's cool. So, you know, I hope everyone's doing well. We got snow today. A little, you know, information about what's going on in the world today. It's November 20th, 2016, if you're watching this in the far future, which I don't know why anyone would. Anyway, so, yeah, we actually got our first snow of the year today. So it's we're in this, you know, I moved, if you watch the Simply Magic pack, I moved a couple months ago, like several months ago now at this point, but so I kind of got freaked out because I was like, wait, I didn't winterize the house, you know, and I kind of, the old house, we had several outdoor faucets and that kind of stuff that I had to really winterize, and this one, I couldn't come up with anything that I needed to, so hopefully I didn't just kind of completely space and forget anything, because, you know, I guess I'll find out, no doubt about it, if I forgot something, so. All right, so I'm going to finish this stuff. My wife just walked in the room here, and I will be back in one second.
And ready for some detail work. So I got all these pillars sort of done. So this is just kind of like the, I guess, the bulk portion of them, and that's pretty good. So next, I want to jump up here to the top so I have a good idea of what I want to do up here. So I think what I want to do is one block below the outside here is do a slope. Well, I was gonna copy it, but let's wait and see if it's okay. I am not that great at doing this with a jetpack, man. All right, we're so far away from any other flight, though. I better just get good at it. So, okay, so there's the beginning. Yeah, that's about what I want. That's good. So let's copy that over here. So, oh, I think I missed one. So one below the lower part gets those two, and then this. So is this right? Wait, so that's even with that. Now I gotta go one more. Alright, and then I gotta count, make sure I know how many of those there were. So I can copy that, okay. So it looks like I went 1, 2, 3, I'm good, 1, 2, 3. Cool, so this is gonna be like sort of the bracket that holds the aqueduct up. Now, maybe I should use a different block. I don't mind that standing out a little bit. Uh-oh. Freezing or crashing? Oh, whew. Okay. Freezing and averted. Okay, cool. By the way, I don't know if I've ever mentioned this. I have got to have the most, like, patient and understanding wife on the planet Earth. I remember years ago, several years ago, whenever I said, hey, so there's this game I want to try on my phone. Like, I know it's like a kid's game, but it looks really fun. It's called, you know, Minecraft. I want to try it out. She's like, yeah, get the game. See if you like it, whatever, you know. And then, I really like the game. I might want to try it on my computer. She's like, oh, yeah, that sounds great. Listen, you know, a couple years go by. Listen, I think I'm going to start recording this stuff. And other than a little eye roll, she is like completely, you know, all right, yeah, go have fun. Have fun with your friends. It's a remarkable woman, and I am very lucky. All right, so this one's going to be the only different one. That I need to go here. This one's going to be a little bit messed up, 1, 2, 3, because of this right here, because I can't do, so instead, I'm going to do a double, so I'll go over here again. Turn and just do these two. Okay. 1, 2. And do the same thing again. 1, 2, 3. Cool. Alright, let's break this guy. Then we'll just see. Now, I don't know exactly how this is going to work at the turn yet, but. Oh, this is really hard with this. This is really hard with this stupid jetpack. All right. So that's good. I'm just not gonna have. Yeah, I don't know if that'll look funny or not, but I'm almost out of fuel. I need to go back and recharge the jetpack soon. Let's get one more done before we go back. So. Check also how to build materials. So let's go 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. These two. Cool. At least this jetpack holds a lot more since I upgraded to the tier 3. If I were trying this with a lower tier, I would have just given up. It's like building in a vanilla. Well, no, it's nothing like. It's not nearly that bad, but it's kind of like building in vanilla mode where you have to always like pillar up and stand on things. Oh, that's no fun at all. Alright, so let's go recharge and make sure I have enough materials to keep going. Now, here's where I should be able to... One thing I want to check here is I want to check and make sure that these are... Stop. Are these... Good. They are oak leaves, so that's what I was hoping. That's why I went ahead and got all those oak leaves, because I need to fill in that big mistake that happened there. So... That's a great fortunate turn there. That's not jungle leaves, because jungle leaves are a much bigger pain to harvest. All right, there and there we go. All right, so this will take a little bit. So I guess I'll cut here and then come back once I am back over at the aqueduct ready to kind of finish at least the support system of these pillars. So I'll be back in just a minute. All right, I'm back. I just ready to sleep here, actually, because mobs are coming out. And actually, one zombie spawned up on the tree right where I was trying to build. So it reminded me that I am not invulnerable. So, yeah, so this is where we got. So looking from the ground, except for that one oak leaf that I missed up there, that actually looks pretty good, pretty solid. Let me kill these creepers and skeleton and other creeper. You know, I don't know exactly why, but from a range, this crossbow seems to have more power. Like, it one-shots most of these guys, except for zombies for some reason, from range, but it doesn't one-shot them if I'm really close. That's weird. I don't know why that is. Now, I'm not doing a support here because this is going to be where the actual house starts, so... that's fine. So that's going well. Since, also, I haven't been over here in, since I did some off-camera farming and stuff, I should just peek over here and just show you guys what I'm continuing to work on for this stupid watering can that's so difficult to get. I mean, I know it's expert mode, but oh, come on. Anyway, so where we're at, let's see. I have one of these. I have one rye, and I might actually have more than one rye, but I have one rye at least, so I'm kind of waiting... You know, I don't think I have any more crops, so I should be doing while I'm over here, and this is all moving. I wonder if I have any crops. Do I have any? No. Do I have any wood? I do have wood, okay. Let me make some. Might as well do this. Okay, so it has to be done anyway, right? Right. Alright, so let me just make a ton of crops, and... That'll be a ton of crops. Cool. I'll throw these guys in here just so I have them. Okay. What I do need more rye, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this and this. It seems to me that weeds must not happen in this version or they're turned off because you have to do so much of it. Maybe, I don't know why, but weeds were a big pain when we did Infinity regular mode a few times ago. You just had to really watch or else weeds would take over your whole garden, and I have not had any spawn, so I have no real problem walking away from this as is now. Okay, let's see. Watering, it's still caught up in any eye. Okay, cool. So I have corn now. No problem. That one's done. Beet seed, let's see. Carrot seeds I have, but I don't have radish. I have tomato, not Brussels sprout. I have cabbage, but not peas. I want to say I have... Oh, no, you know what? I think I'm waiting to get soybean, actually. Maybe. Bean and rice. Yeah, you know what? This is going to make rice. That's what I'm hoping. If this makes rice... then I can use that. So I'm still a ways off. It's really Shocking how far I have yet to go, but a lot of these things that have spawned, you know, actually I have nothing, I'm not really waiting for anything else. You know what? That son of a, I didn't have a crop on this, so nothing was going to even happen ever. Anyway, okay, so yeah, so I learned that you have to put like a bucket of water in here to get rice to spawn. I don't know what else can spawn, hopefully only rice, because that would be really nice. And then once I get rice, then I can move on to, I think, what is it, peas next maybe, or soybean, I don't know. Anyway, but I'm not going to do, I just decided I'm not going to do any more of that on camera, because it is just, it's so tedious. You know, it's fine, I'm not really complaining that much, because it's kind of fun. But it is really boring to sit there. I mean, building, if you think building is boring, well, building is much less boring than sitting there doing agrocraft. Although, you know, it's fine. I have a good time doing it. So the next thing I want to do is I want to figure out if I want to go, what I want to do is I want to add some depth down along here. Now, there's a few ways to do it, but I think the main thing I want to do here is probably do something like this. Like, nope, I missed the very first thing I tried to do. Okay, maybe like do something like this. Maybe something like this. This is a test. Now that looks really lame. It's a nice idea, but it's like bigger than the base, so that's not gonna work at all. Yeah, that's just not even gonna work. Good idea, good concept, and I might use that kind of thing at some other point, but yeah, it can't be bigger than the base, that's definitely not. What I could do is I could use a different carpenter, I could use like a carpenter's fence, or I think it might be actually be called carpenter's barrier. You know what else I could do to give it a little bit of looks is something like this. How's that? Doesn't really work, does it? Because of this coming out. So what I could do then is maybe something like this. Let's see, how about this? Like these two? Alright, how's that? That might be kind of cool. And then I'm thinking like one, two, and then something like that. So one, two. I need to go around the corner just so I can see it. Alright. How's that? You know what? I actually really like that. Let's do a test run on this pillar. Oh, that... Nope. That can't be. How many did it go? I did go three, I guess. Oh, I see one. Because I did this, so... And then I went one, two... That, right? Okay, so then... like this, and then one more here, right? One. Okay, how's that? That is pretty cool. I think the only thing is I need is something like right there. Yeah, definitely. I definitely need that one there for sure. But yeah, so I like that. Gives it a little round and helps the pillar sort of taper off. So now the only thing, I like that actually. The only thing I don't like about this as far as a building aesthetic point of view is this sort of area right here. I like above it, I like below it. Just this part doesn't work as much. So you know what might work? Oh, you know what might work? Crap, I just used all of my my wood, didn't I? Okay, let me see if I have, do I maybe have any more wood? The odds are not strong. I have literally one piece of wood. Okay. No, I don't have any more. Oh, but wait, you know what I do have? I have these regular trees over here I planted for some reason. These are just regular old trees that I did. These aren't like custom trees, so I don't have any problem cutting these down. Well, that'll, cool, now I have wood. Now I can make some carpenter's blocks. That's awesome. Kind of making sure that none of these are custom, but I'm almost sure that I just planted these saplings just to have some kind of like wood on hand for actually a situation exactly like what I just did, like when I'm like, oh crap, I need something here and I don't want to go the whole way back to base. At some point, I'm gonna have a road, you know, leading back to base, so that'll be really nice. Wow, I have a lot of saplings. This whole area is gonna be filled in with maybe like, I don't know what, maybe, I don't think I'm gonna use wheat. I think I might use barley actually instead. I kind of like the texture of barley in this pack a little bit more, and I think that could be really cool. So let's see, throw that down. Okay, cool. So I have wood, so let's make some carpenters. Wow, I have a lot of wood. That big tree, I guess. So let's check here. I actually forget. I want carpenter. Here, this one. Oh, carpenter's barrier. Okay. Oh, it's like that. Okay. Oh, regular sticks too. Hmm. Okay. Cool. And let's make some of these guys. Yeah, I'll use them. Okay. So let's try this. Let's see how this goes. I like the looks of that. I like the water wheels into the house. I think that's pretty cool. You know, it would be pretty cool if I had a way out of here. So I think I'm gonna just create a door right here. That way I can get in and out of my house. Okay, so what I'm thinking is maybe something like this. I think this might be the answer, maybe. Or it might be really lame, I'm not sure which. Okay, it's not there yet, but what if I do this? Oh, does it stick out? It does stick out, doesn't work because of that, darn it. I almost like it. Almost, but not quite, right? Could it be a texture thing? Let me see here. Let's try those two. Okay, I definitely like that better. That sticks out more, so that's good. Let me do more than one and see. See if it changes my mind after I have a few down here. Alright, how's that? I mean, it's definitely more interesting, for sure. I like it, pretty much. You know what? Actually, what I don't like is, like, this now, actually. Could I come out? Hold on, what if I... Okay, hold on a second. I'm having an idea. What if I just came out like this? Made it even thicker. I think that might be the answer. Let me see here. Yep, that is definitely the answer. Yeah, like 1,000 times more. In fact, it almost looks like a furnace, doesn't it? Yeah, nice. I need to sleep. I always forget. Cool. All right. So let's do this, and then I think maybe I'm close to finished with this aqueduct. I think that is that's a pretty interesting build. I think I'm only using two blocks, which I have a rule. I don't know if I've said it or not. I have kind of a self-imposed rule about building, and that rule is that buildings, in my own stupid opinion, buildings should only use about three different textures of blocks, different kinds of blocks. Any more than that, and I think it gets a little hodgepodge-ish, a little bit. I mean, I've seen, I shouldn't say it because it's not always, but it can. It can. I think you have to be really, really careful if, not. That's not even the right thing. These should be just like that, and then this, I guess. Is this even right? You know what? I'm just going to take this. I want to see all my beautiful work here, right? Yeah, that'll be cool. So, I'm having trouble remembering how to mimic this exactly. Oh, I didn't do the upper half on this. Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah, so that's the problem. So, it's three up, right? One, two, three. And slope. Right? One, two, three. Slope. Okay. All right, so we'll just fill this in. Three, slope. So I hope everyone is enjoying kind of seeing this island come to life, you know. It's, like I said, this is going to be a very, very, very long project. So I could see, you know, I can't see necessarily watching all of these episodes. I don't necessarily think that is really the point. I think probably this is more the kind of thing that you would, like, you know, pop in, skip ahead, say, it's like, oh, that building is, nope, that's not right. Oh, that building is cool. Let's watch the construction of that thing, or whatever, something like, or, you know, or not cool. I don't know, whatever. But yeah, this needs to come up here, or else it's gonna be like a mob haven, right? Okay, so that's cool. And I'm missing something here. All right, yeah. This goes like that, I think. That, yeah, okay, that's what I'm missing. Yeah, it's this block. What I like about that is back behind there gives you a little depth. Anyway, like I was saying, is, you know, this might not be a series that you actually watch like every single episode of. I would not necessarily think that it is. I think it'd be more like, you know, pop in, just check out a couple episodes, see what's going on, whatever, that kind of thing. So that's, you know, that's fine with me. It's gonna be long enough. I know, who is it? Ethos, maybe, I think. I'm kind of going off memory here, but he has like a vanilla series that's like hundreds, like 450 episodes long type of thing, which, yes, might be a goal that I've kind of considered. anyway, and you know, that I think that's a series that maybe you don't necessarily watch everyone. I'm sure some people do, but it's more like, you know, pop in, it's like, whoa, that's sweet, and then pop back out again, something like that. So anyway, hope, whoa, that's sweet, that would be a cool reaction. I hope someone thinks that. So yeah, so is this one the same as the other one? I think it looks like it is. The second to last one is the one that I'm a little bit worried about, actually. Oops, I need more brick. Okay. Because I'm worried that this is going to hit the top, and I may have to make an alternate design on that one. Because I don't know how many blocks I have between what's going to finish, like, these, and where the water is actually running. Because it's the mountain kind of gets up there. So I'll find out really soon, I think. So let's see if I can I remember this? That's the question. I can remember it, but I can't click on the right block. All right. So after I'm done recording this, it's only 10:26 p.m. And I you know, like, I'm a musician, you know, so, like, I stay up fairly late, because part of the deal is, you know, it's Sunday night, right? So last night, I didn't get home from work until, jeez, what time did I get home? Like 2:15 in the morning. So I've always had a hard time. Like, one day I get home at 2:15 in the morning, and then realistically I'm not going to bed right at 2:15. You know, I'm gonna throw on ESPN, see what's going on, whatever, something like that. Maybe have a decaf or something before bed. I think I got that right. Oh, that one looks really cool. Like halfway up the building, I like that a lot. This is the one I'm worried about. Let's find out. Anyway, so I get home at 2:30 in the morning one day. Look, it's gonna exactly fit. And then the next day, like, you know, my family goes to bed at 10 or so, which, you know, is fine, because my wife has to get up really early tomorrow morning for work, and I get that completely. But I can't go to bed at 10 one day and 3 the next day, so, and back and forth. So basically I stay pretty consistent and staying up fairly late. Also, that's with my son, especially watching him all day, that's like kind of the time that I get to myself, to kind of, you know, play a game or watch, you know, Walking Dead or something, or whatever I want to do, you know, that kind of thing that I really enjoy. So, how am I doing? Fuel's still good. Okay, I'm going to try to finish this, and then hopefully the aqueduct, hopefully I feel like it's pretty close to in a good place to wrap up work on this. I wasn't sure I would get this done in an episode, actually, but so far so good. Spoke too soon. Let's see here.
There we go.
All right, and then the last thing is just bring these guys up to right. Oh, you know what?
Okay, first I had to look. I forgot the fence post in this one. That's okay. Really not a big deal at all, but I did forget to put them in, so I'll have to do that. And then I think I'm in a good wrapping up point. This, I think, should probably be a block. Yeah, should be. Okay, cool. So let's throw these fence in. I just got done chiseling away all of these, so I need to have some of these like that. Okay, cool. And then, here's the barrier. Cool. Yeah, I really like that barrier. That was, I think, a good choice. Actually, I think this whole aqueduct was a good choice. I really like the looks of this. I think it's kind of hitting the sweet spot between like bulky and what's a good word? Like maybe bulky, but not necessarily just bulky. But I think it has good like stability. Like it looks like it could actually hold that up. Except for I forgot to do these ones too, so I gotta take these down and throw in the barriers here too. Yeah, barriers definitely the way to go. I did that actually in the Simply Magic series. I did that where I had whatever the blood magic ritual is for calling a storm, I think, because I needed to summon the Ars Magica Lightning Guardian. So I did that, and did the same kind of thing. Like, I had the thing in there, but I used these carpenter's blocks, barriers on the outside, and really, really give a cool look. Yeah, so you know what? I think... Oh, nope, we're not done. I forgot. I have one more, and I've got to deal with this. There we go. Okay, one more. I lied. I should have enough... I just had the wrong thing. Hopefully I have enough materials. That would be a drag if I have to go back to my base just to finish this last one. Let's see, what else? You know what else? This dirt needs to go. Not all of it, but at least two pieces of it. That's cool. That's good. So let's see, 1, 2, 3. Throw this up there. Let's get rid of one of those. That's cool. That's good. Okay, that's all good. And then this one here. Cool. So in the Direwolf series, if you haven't watched it, it's a water server. So I had this. What I think, anyway, is a really cool idea for like a floating futuristic sci-fi base. Boy, what a jarring difference it is between, you know, completely, like, medieval, stone, fantasy, Dungeons & Dragons, wizard sort of look versus, what, you know, I'm planning to be, like, a, really, like, streamlined look. But what I've discovered is, in the Dire Pack, and it's really a drag to me, there is Chiseled Abyss, which is awesome. Chiseled Abyss is a really sweet mod. But what there isn't... Carpenter's blocks yet. Now, I read on the Carpenter's Blocks forum that is being worked on, but it's not here yet, and I don't know if Dire will include it in his pack. Spoiler alert for those who watch this series and play my pack, if he doesn't include it whenever it's ready, I think we might, because selfishly, I want it in my build. That looks pretty great. Guys, I'm pretty psyched about this. I won't even lie to you guys. I am really psyched about that. I think those pillars look freaking great. Love it. Hey, Creeper. Did I miss? There he goes. Anyway, so that's it for me today. Aqueduct, I'm going to call done, I think. At some point, I might want to light it up. I might use barriers. I might do something like that. I'm not sure what yet, but for now... done. So that's it for me, guys. Insert your catchphrase. Thank you so much for watching a kind of let's build, and I will see you guys next time.